dedicate this to Harold, who's a friend of Barbara's, and to Chiara, who's a friend of Lucy's, as they cross over to the other side, and to any one of us that we know that is making that journey right now. So Om Namo Narayanaya, as the soul merges with the great divine light, we can give this mantra on their way as a blessing.
Om Namo.
Namo Narayanaya.
Namaste, friends.
Namaste.
Welcome. Nice to be with each other again. Nice to be connected again. Nothing much to say, but plenty to sing about. So let's move straight into our meditation practice, shall we? There's no time like now. So lighten our candles, lighten our incense, and settling down into our power spot in our room. Invoking our spiritual teachers and giving thanks to our ancestors. All down through the ages, we're here together because of them. And we close our eyes. With the beautiful mantra Om Namo Narayana in our hearts, we settle down, slowing down our heartbeat, bringing our attention to the sounds around us as our heartbeat slows down. Chant the mantra Om with Deva and making sure to take deep breaths as we chant together. This is the key. The breath is the key.
To you and most vibrant to you, whether to sing and chant Aum, Om, or just humming with closed lips. It's really about tuning in and seeing what's right for us at this moment.
So with our eyes closed, let's just come back to the space of stillness. We remind each other here that meditation is not a serious business, not by any means. It is not serious, but it is a sincere activity. And if our sincerity is strong, if our back is straight, our spine is straight, then the meditation contains a strong intensity which opens the door to the light of the Gayatri Mantra and the Mantra Om. And don't forget, in your moments of closing your eyes, I'm doing it now myself because I'm reminded that Deva yesterday told us to bring our gaze up to the center of our forehead, into our sixth chakra, into the third eye. Bring your gaze up there behind your closed eyes. Already there is light there. Already there is light. And when we finish the meditation, you will go back to this light and feel just how much light there is inside yourself and all your fellow meditators around the world. It's a beautiful thing to be connected all across the world the same time, breathing together and meditating in peace together with a smile. Like I said, it's not serious meditation, it is sincere. There's a big difference. If we're sincere in our meditations, we can smile. You can't smile if you're serious. There's no chance. This is about being sincere, bringing a smile to your belly, being grateful for the breath in our bodies as we chant with Deva, the cosmic yes.
And as I play, we can already hear it. We can already hear it within. It's already vibrating within. And we're already swimming in the sound. It's just about at one point giving voice to it, or adding our voice to it. Thank you. part of this whole that we are experiencing in this human life. Every chakra is needed for the full experience.
Thank you.
have your eyes open. Let's close your eyes. This is a nice moment to bring our hands to the center of our chest, to our heart center. Just holding that space of love and compassion and forgiveness. This is the qualities of the fourth chakra, the heart chakra. And as you bring your hands to the center, raise your gaze to your third eye and embrace all this light that we have created and that we have received through our chanting today.
And a sense of compassion for this human family that we are part of and that we going through this common experience with, and compassion for how each and everyone deals with it and does their best to deal with it, including ourselves. Maybe a little smile of compassion, like a smile that is not quite so identified with it, just a little detachment from the situation. And the gaze in our third eye chakra helps us to detach for a moment.
And straighten your spine again. Relax shoulders. In this moment we are thousands of Buddhas all across the world sitting together in love and compassion for each other and for ourselves.
You're so tall. <Or that. laughs> Greatest.
The greatest challenge. Now, some of you told me that you like to hear my stories of my time with Osho. This song, it's called The Greatest Challenge, and my guitar is back, but it's not quite recovered yet. Anyway, the song The Greatest Challenge, it kind of explains and says something about the life of a disciple. And of course, it's very often misunderstood, the relationship between guru and devotee. It's misunderstood as if it's slave master relationship. No, but I think many people still have that understanding. Yeah. And anyway, I want to say it because it's part of my reality that with Osho, the greatest challenge was to make a personal commitment, not be told this is what you have to do. Osho never told us what we had to do. He always suggested and left it up to the individual to make the decision. And in a way, that was the greatest challenge, because it's so much easier to be told, you have to get up at 4 a.m., you have to do this, you have to do that, you have to do this meditation. He never did that. It was always thrown back on the individual. So this song is called The Greatest Challenge, and of course that situation turns to be the greatest blessing also, because you find your own inner strength. And I'm very grateful to the Master for it. I can see you when I look beneath the surface of my life. Here in the silence, where no sound has ever been heard, calling me on like a song in the distance, calling like a fire in the heart. And to answer your call is the greatest challenge of all. To answer your call is the greatest challenge. Of my friends, I see you in their eyes the same way they see you in mine, calling us on like a song in the distance. Not now, when? If not here, where?
if not me? Who could I be? When I look beneath the surface of my life, here in the silence where no sound has ever been heard, like a song in the distance, calling me on, like a fire in the heart, and to answer your call, it's the greatest challenge. To answer your call, it's the greatest challenge of all. To answer your call, it's the greatest challenge of all. But to answer your greatest blessing of all.
It's like that, and it's like this. We all have our own teachers, and we're all grateful for the teachings they give us. I know for myself, some of the teachers I've had gave me some tough lessons, because the heart gets broken, and through the open heart we move into a new perspective in life, and a new perspective of who we are and what our purpose is in life. And when we get to that, we can give thanks to the person who hurt us, because they gave us a lesson that otherwise we would not have had. And the lessons that we've received are exactly the reason that we all sit in here together today, in gratitude and in forgiveness. Thank you so much for joining us. We love you. Loka samasta.
Almost.
Loka samasta. Sukhino bhavantu. Loka samasta. Sukhino. Samasta, samasta, sukino, sukino, bhavantu, bhavantu, loka, loka, samasta, sukino, bhavantu, loka, samasta.
Namaste.
Namaste.